you love this American shit, but really the truth is you're scared of the six. Yeah, you're scared of the six. Yeah, you're scared of the six.
Why does Drake keep texting teenagers? Everyone remembers when Drake was texting Millie Bobby Brown, giving her dating advice, which many people found to be super weird.
We just texted each other the other day and he was like, I miss you so much. I was like, I miss you more.
What advice does he give you? Like, what does he say?
About boys, he helps me.
But he also used to text Billie Eilish when she was younger, despite them having a 15-year age gap.
Drake is like the nicest dude I've ever spoken to. I mean, I've only like texted him, but.
I met Drake in an Australian hotel. And honestly, we text all the time now. He helps me with everything, like just life lessons.
What does he say?
About boys, he helps me.
Hey Drake, I hate you like I'm young. Certified lover boy, certified pedophile. Why you trolling like a bitch? Ain't you tired? Trying to strike a chord and it's probably A minor.
All right, so Drake, you have made it to the Rosenberg flip cam. Is this the ultimate sign that you finally made it?
Yes. Actually, there's they were just telling me that Kanye said some great things about me in the press, and I was like, cool, but I haven't been on Rosenberg yet.
So. I know that's the shit you were fucking waiting for, man.
So I haven't made it.
So, honestly, like, just for people who don't really understand what the situation is, like, I do these Who's Next every month, and
yep.
We've had some, you know, pretty good guests with Buzz on it, whatever. Mm-hmm. But like, this is a fucking zoo. And you seem normal. Like, you've been incredibly cool. Like, I didn't even know this guy from Adam when I first reached out to him, and just been nothing but gracious and cool. But you have to be becoming a douchebag. This is crazy.
I can't, man. You know what? Honestly, I have some phenomenal figures around me that would never let me become.
You're saying this, you know what you're saying this as you sip. Is that hot water with lemon or is that tea? Is that tea?
Look, I never drink tea before a show. It's just cold out here, so I just, you know, I want to give a great show.
No, you got to get your voice right, man. Yeah. I understand. It's the same shit, you know, every night before everyone's Vegas show. You know, what's her face? Celine Dion, a Canadian. I almost fucking forgot her name in front of probably one of your heroes.
Nice Roots sweater, by the way.
Yeah, I did reference Roots. By the way, which I didn't realize Roots, shout out to all the Canadians out there, that Roots isn't cool anymore. Mm-hmm. And I, like, go to Toronto. I still want to go to Eaton Centre and stop by Roots, and I get no love for the Roots
at all.
Where can I go to get fresh gear when I'm in Toronto?
You go to Goodfoot and Ransom.
Goodfoot and Ransom?
Goodfoot and Ransom and Nomad. It's on Richmond Street, and it's the best place to go to get fresh.
Says the man who's sipping the tea. Take it. That was a commercial. That was a commercial for Folgers Crystals,
yeah.
Right there. Yo, so I remember actually. Let's see if you're not gonna remember this. I'm sure, but I started working on a little record a while ago, like 2 years ago. Called T.O. Gambino's. It was a cover of Wu Gambino's for a project called Only Built for Jewish Links, which I did not put out yet. It's being held up.
Yeah.
I got all these artists on it, mm-hmm. And my man who set it up was like, I'm going to get Drake for you.
I
was like, I don't know who the fuck Drake is, mm-hmm. But that sounds great, man. He's like, well, listen, he's already kind of a big deal around here, so it might be tough. Mm-hmm. We got Cardinal, got Socrates.
Remember that.
I never got my Drake verse.
I remember that.
How can we still do it?
I don't know.
You have to be on T.O. Gambino's.
You got to talk to G and Tez now, man.
Who do I?
It's the gatekeepers. Roberson.
You just sent me to a gate. Was it because the T jokes? Did I take it too far?
Never
too far.
Wu Gambino's cover?
You have to do that. How could you not do that? T.O. Gambino's? Yo, so let's talk about you being Jewish real quick.
Let's do that.
Because a lot of people think that, like, Asher's Jewish.
Right.
He's not. His dad's Jewish. He doesn't really identify. All loves to Jews, but he's not Jewish.
Yeah.
You, on the other hand...
But he wasn't there. He didn't read his portion, first of all.
You didn't have a bar mitzvah.
Come on. Are you serious?
You had a... Hold on, ladies and gentlemen. Just tell... You don't understand how big you're about to be in the Jew world.
You don't understand how big.
First
of all, I live in an all-Jewish area. So
where is that?
Forest Hill.
Okay.
I went to a predominantly Jewish school growing up. I definitely had a bar mitzvah in an Italian restaurant, mind you.
My lord.
Yeah.
A nice Italian restaurant?
A very nice Italian restaurant. The song of the night was Backstreet Boys, I Want It That Way.
You are younger than me, my friend. I forget about that.
And man, I was in there. I was in synagogue. I had my yarmulke on.
Hebrew school, the whole nine. You did. No Hebrew
school? I cheated. I didn't really.
So you just did that? No. Your parents are nice.
Yeah.
So they let you do the bar mitzvah without having to do the fucking Hebrew school. Mm-hmm. So your mom's Jewish.
My mother is Jewish. And you know we have great Jewish dinners like Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur.
First text message you ever sent me. Good Shabbos.
Yep, good Shabbos.
He kept it real.
Yep.
Have you gotten approached yet by like the Jewish media yet?
No, I haven't gotten approached by the Jewish media, but somebody today who I won't mention, was like, you know how big you're going to be? And I was like...
Wait, was that me 5 minutes ago?
I remember saying that.
Somebody's like, you know how big you're going to be? And he's like, this has never happened before. It's like every Jew is going to just like really embrace.
Well, here's the thing. There are Jews like my dad who like cling to like the biggest reaches. Yeah. Like, you know who's Jewish? Matt Damon. I'm like, no, he's not, Dad. He's definitely not Jewish. And like people reach, and the fact that you actually identify, that's gonna be like, that's gonna be big.
Yeah, it's gonna be crazy.
You're doing something that I could never do. You're being black and Jewish, man.
I know.
I'm never, it's never gonna fucking happen. No, I've tried. I fucking tried. Ask everyone at North Chevy Chase Elementary School and Westland Middle School. I tried my hardest, but at the end of the day, I'm here wearing shorts in cold weather and long sleeves. You know what I'm saying?
It's all good.
So in all seriousness, though, like, is this a little crazy?
Yeah, no, it's beyond a little crazy, you know, but the key is to keep my composure and just know that at the end of the day, these are all human beings, and they are all here for a positive reason, which is to see a good show. And it's on me to give it to them. If I don't, then I'm the worst artist of all time. So
do you feel any pressure to do some like really good shit for hip hop? Because like you could go left. You're getting tied up. The Rihanna rumors, crazy Perez Hilton. Like you're in. You know what I mean? Like you're in that stratosphere now to some extent. How do you make sure that like you don't let us down? You know what I'm saying? Like, because hardcore hip hop heads have a lot of faith in you as well.
Well, I can honestly say that I'm surrounded by some of the greatest people that have been preserving hip hop, you know, for the last 5 years. Like a lot of the individuals that have kept it alive and restored people's faith, you know, like Kanye, like Wayne, like Jay, just phenomenal guys, phenomenal people, and phenomenal artists. So I think just being constantly in the presence of them and inspired by them is a thing right there. Is an honor.
Pardon this PSA interruption.
You know, normally I would be mad. Normally I would be mad about someone interrupting my interview,
but it's Kanye. Peter Rosenberg, man. How are you?
You don't know, Kanye, do you know why I'm like this?
Yeah. Y'all have a request for T-Pain Flight School and Kanye West. We're not playing that tonight. I know you are.
Kanye is in the building. Yo, is that weird? Is that weird in general, just having Kanye just like show up at your shit?
No.
Melissa asks, tweets, Drake claims he wasn't cool in high school. What made you uncool?
I just didn't, there was a... It wasn't that I wasn't cool, it was that the kids that were cool, I wasn't on their wavelength, which made me sort of uncool, I guess. So like, you know, it was, I just always felt like an outsider. I went, when I was in Forest Hill, you know, it was an all Jewish school, like, and just being biracial, but still being Jewish, so I was like kind of connected to the kids, but like sort of distant. And when, you know, when kids are young, they don't necessarily comprehend everything.
Right.
So it can get a little cruel and a little mean.
You get teased a lot?
Yeah. I mean, I got it, you know. I got it, definitely.
Were you raised Jewish by your mom?
Not like, you know, not like Orthodox Jew or like extremely religious Jewish. We celebrated every holiday and you know, I actually had a bar mitzvah. Mm-hmm. But I was raised in a Jewish household, I would say. But my mother's a very, you know, my mother was always like, you do what makes you happy. You be with who you want to be with, and as long as you're happy, as long as you're safe, and you're not bringing trouble into my home.
So you decide to take this music path, and you know, in the bigger scope of things, it doesn't take that long before you blow up in the United States. But in the early moments when you're pursuing this, what was the response you get as a Canadian black Jewish rapper trying to get attention in the U.S.?
I think that details of my like background kind of came afterwards. I think what caught first was the music. And I think what became almost more appealing was like, this is the guy that, I remember those moments from people like, wait, this guy is this guy? Like people really, you know, drawing the connection. And I always say, I wouldn't have it any other way, man. I wouldn't have it any other way because I truly don't know if I'd be here if I didn't have so much to potentially overcome as some people may look at it. I mean, to
me. You don't look at it that way?
Not really. Because, you know, I'm from Toronto. I'm from a place where it's a true mosaic. You know, there's
We're to me the most open-minded place you can possibly find yourself. So I don't ever look at it as that, you know. But there are other places that you go where it's just not so. It's not that simple, you know. And yeah, I never looked at it as overcoming anything. I was just like, man, I just got to be a good rapper. But you know, to a lot of other people, they were like, wait, what? You're Canadian, you're Jewish, and you're half. You know, it's just like mind-blowing things to them. But like I said, yeah, I don't think that, you know, it wasn't like on my mixtape cover, it just said like the new Canadian half black Jewish. Like, it wasn't like advertised.
Not so people, Yahoo.
People had to go kind of find out about me. And I think when they did, it made the story even more interesting. I wouldn't want that to change.
I'm an Orthodox Jew and I've known Drake for over 15 years. Here's a video of me and him in the nightclubs before I was religious. Yeah. Somebody just sent me the ridiculous video from Kendrick Lamar dissing my boy Drake. And there's one thing that stood out to me that kept on repeating itself over and over in the song. Kendrick Lamar keeps on saying, "They not like us." And Kendrick, you are absolutely right. Drake is not like you. Because Drake is a Jew. He's the son of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's part of the Jewish people, part of the greatest story ever told. Now, Drake, like many others, is lost in the world and doesn't always know how to reveal his Jewish soul. But when you say, "They not like us," you're 100% right. He's not like you. He's royalty. So to my boy Drake, I hope this reaches you. Remember, they are telling you very clearly, you are not like them. You are a Jewish man. Be proud, be loud, and stand up and be counted for who you truly are.
Jewish, or recite a Jewish prayer like Baruch Yitadel Yisrael Vita Kim Kardashian Kanye West. Amen.
Minnesota asks, who has been your favorite artist to work with and why?
Oh, I have to say, I can't say one person. I gotta say there's three people that I have to say. Well, me and Jay have like the greatest relationship, so every time we work, it's always fun. No matter what we're doing, music or just shows or whatever, we have a phenomenal relationship. So I love working with Jay. In the studio, the greatest experience I had was with Alicia Keys. She made it so comfortable for me to be there. And just, you know, I was a little intimidated and overwhelmed, and she just made me feel right at home. And we came up with a great song, which is Unthinkable, the song that's out right now. And Wayne is my favorite person to work with, though, because it's just, ooh, Lil Wayne, he's just too good.
You got to give Wayne the love.
He's just too good.
Drake, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And viewers, thank you for all of your great questions. Drake's album, Thank Me Later, comes out June 15th.
But he wasn't always a rapper when he got into the entertainment industry. He started off as a child actor. It's rather a common phenomenon than an exception when celebrities who start as child actors when growing older become singers, or vice versa. Drake, alongside other celebrities such as Ariana Grande, Miley Cyrus, Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, Justin Timberlake, and many others, really got their first bite into celebrity stardom as a child actor, eventually transitioning into musicians. But what made Drake change his path into a musician, give up acting, and was he always rich?
Sean Cameron. Jimmy Brooks. Thought me and you were cool, man.
There is no me and you.
Fine by me.
Why One warning, though. You stay away from my girl.
What are you talking about?
Ash and I are a thing again.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Guess I'll have to ask her that when I take her out on Friday.
Hey! 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 Take it easy!
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Jimmy knows what's good for him.
Aubrey is the leader on set.
He's really humble. He's really sweet. Completely charming. Just smooth. He's a total ladies' man.
The girls just eat him up.
He's very wise and he's very funny.
He's my boy. I'm Aubrey Graham and this is my life. Unscripted.
What's up, everybody? You're chilling with me, Aubrey Graham. You guys want to go for a ride? We can go for a ride. This is my baby, I guess. It's a 2004 Acura TSX. It's a nice first car for like a teenager, I guess, as opposed to a Mercedes or BMW. I think that's pretentious, personally. But hey, if you have the money to buy it, then feel free. Enough about the car. Let's go inside. Hey, Bubby. Yeah. Me and my grandma have a little thing where my mom doesn't let her eat chocolate, but my grandma slides me a little extra cheddar on the side, and I make sure she gets her daily chocolate dose.
That's so. My grandson.
This is the living room, and it's nice and elegant, and I kind of leave this alone. It's too much for me. This is our dining room, and here's my mother making notes as usual on probably some
transposing my to-do list.
Yeah, exactly. Through here, this is our wonderful fridge with stock because, you know, there were people over today, so we had to get some food. Now we're gonna check out MySpace. This is my space. This is where I live. And through here, this is my living room. I like a chilling vibe. That's my favorite thing about this basement. I made this table. Got Barry White, Frank Sinatra, Notorious B.I.G. Everybody around this table has basically inspired me to get into music, particularly Pharrell. He's like one of my idols. So this is where I sit and sometimes write. And actually, we missed a very important thing. I write songs and that's what I like. I do music. These are full from front to back of just songs. Pages and pages of lyrics and ideas. Something that I'll probably never use, but I mean, because they're old, I just like to keep them around for nostalgia purposes. And this is my dad, and him and my uncle worked with Al Green. That's basically why I do it. I mean, he taught me everything. So thank you, Dad. I don't get to see you that often, but you know, my love is always with you. And then through here, this is my comfort area. As you can see, I recently did laundry. This is actually a very nice couch. And in here, I have more stuff. Some sweaters and t-shirts, some blazers, jackets, and the shoes are a big thing. I got them from bottom to top. You know, at the end of the day, that's material possessions. That's not what I'm about. This is what I'm about. I'm a music fanatic, so. So I got some fads from Marvin Gaye, Kanye West, Big L, Jay-Z, all the Jay-Z albums. I don't know, we could go on for days. I got the studio mic set to my height so I can just flow a little if need be. I've been a mess since every girl I left went and got a new man, but I'm the new version of Fresh Prince. And the bands got bumped for real. I switch wifey every season like Uncle Phil. And then the chorus drops. So that was a little verse I wrote. Little something. Yeah, I got some stuff around here. I got Andrea's first single. Yeah, this CD, which is pretty good. It's Chaos. Toronto artist. Supports the Toronto artist. And I got this the other night. It's Allie. It's one of my best friends on Radio Free Roscoe, which is a great show, by the way. Feel free to tune in. This is one of the nicest letters I've ever received from anybody. He feels that I could complete the trifecta of the greatest African-American actors of all time, Roy, Sidney Poitier, Denzel Washington, and he says the third edition would be Aubrey Graham. Jason, I thank you, man, on the real. I never got a chance to respond to you. I hope you're watching this. Thank you so much. I appreciate it with all my heart. And just know that I keep it close, and I will keep this with me for the rest of my life. No matter where I go, you're the one that said it. So if it happens, it happens, man. You called it. And this is my room. This is where I live. This is the life I'm living right now.
We always thought that there was something very different about this kid. When we had a piano at home and I would come home with my nursery rhymes, Aubrey at 3 years old would take the lyrics and he would change them. I realized that other kids just didn't do that. Being an only child, I always had him in a lot of activities, whether it was day camp or whether it was group activities, hockey, a lot of things where you'd have to learn to be a team player.
I was in this program called YPT, which is Young People's Theater, but it was really just a bunch of young kids acting really hyper, and then like we'd throw on masks and call it a play, whatever. I guess the parents thought it was cool.
When Aubrey was about 5 years old, I took him to this agent, and she really liked Aubrey, so he did print work, and which is catalogs, and he did a couple of commercials.
Have you been there tonight? Les Mis was the first thing that people actually liked, I guess, and people actually came to see and clapped for a good reason. They're not like, yeah, it's over. Like, good, let's go.
Apparently they've been auditioning for Degrassi for a whole year or something at all these schools in the city. So it was the last 3 weeks of auditions and he got in.
I was gonna wait till tomorrow, but I think you might need this now. Happy anniversary.
I called Aubrey and I asked him to come home because we lived right across the road from the school at the time. So he came home and then I told him and he, of course, went crazy. He couldn't believe it.
He's a man.
You're looking at him. Grassy Panthers, Jimmy Brooks is on the prowl.
Music and acting are the only things that I can commit to on a regular basis, no matter what.
From Toronto to Tennessee, a town to stay down. OKKK. New Drake album coming soon. You see that? You like that?
That was my grandmother shamelessly promoting the new Drake album, and that's my middle name and also my performance name, so thank you, Bubby.
This is the guy you want to follow, unscripted.
Appreciate that, man.
Completely unscripted.
That touches me right here.
What was that kid's name again?